Kevin Harrington has been a successful entrepreneur for 40 years, an original shark on ABC's Emmy-winning TV show Shark Tank, an inventor of the Infomercial. He's also co-founder of the Entrepreneurs Organization, the world's only peer-to-peer network exclusively for entrepreneurs. These are the three best business decisions he has ever made.
We had 100 infomercials in our library, and I'm sitting there in 1989 saying, how do I get more money out of these assets that I've created? And that's when I thought, well, wait a minute. I looked at the movie industry and I said, movies start in the US and the movies have a bell-shaped curve, but what do? They go international. They go to Europe, they go to England, they go to Germany, they go to Asia, they dub them into dozens of languages and get international distribution. So I said to myself, I wonder if I can take these infomercials into the international arena. So I said, well, where do the movies go? They go to the Cannes Film Festival. So in 1989, I took a booth out at the Cannes Film Festival, a 10-foot by 10-foot booth. And literally, overnight, I got immediate contacts in 100-plus countries for my infomercials. And we literally 10x'd the size of the company over the next 3 years because we took the same asset from the US. The infomercial was already shot, it was already produced. All we had to do was dub it into the local language. We're up to almost $500 million in US dollars. But we ended up setting up all of our own infrastructure everywhere. We set up our own call centers, our own phone centers, our own fulfillment centers, our own everything, because we were doing volume and we thought that, oh, when we contract things out, it costs a little bit more. One by one, we ended up saying, we actually can contract out virtually everything we do and become a virtual company. Because see, we can now go to 4 fulfillment centers and, you know, shave 20% off of our costs, you know, because everybody's wanting that business and we have high volume. In when we get a winner, we'll ship, you know, we're shipping 80,000 pieces a week of one product right now. So somebody wants that business and they're able to handle it because they've got the infrastructure. But by the way, when we got to a hit like that, you know, we had a tough time staffing for the calls, the media, the, you know, that surge staffing was very complex. It also, we didn't have the space for it. We didn't have the manpower for it. And there was sloppy things happening and mistakes being made. So by having great service providers and multiple ones in every category, we actually not only could save money, but we could manage the business better. And I would challenge people that build these big infrastructures to understand what really are their costs on an internal basis if you have to add, you know, those trade shows that you go to and those other things that, you know, the meals and the travel and the this and the that sometimes don't get charged to the right projects. There's actually a study that was done by Morgan Stanley that shows that their TV viewership has dropped in the United States by 50% in the last 10 years. So in the middle of that drop, I could feel it. And I said, I need to move into digital. I need to move into mobile. I started exploring all of the digital space, and we've made a tremendous transition and actually sold some of the assets that I didn't think were going to be, you know, performing as well. And so we now have by going digital and utilizing a lot of the assets that are out there in the digital space, we can, where I used to spend $50,000 minimum to test a new product, for $2,500 or less, sometimes for $500, I can do a test digitally and find out what's the pulse, because we have the ability to get to very specific markets. And so where some people look at digital as a tough thing and, you know, hurting their industry, if you use it properly, it can actually build your business. And now I'm 50-50 digital and 50, the other 50 TV.